there anything you remember from wearing it? Was it comfortable? Anything in particular you remember about the costume and wearing it?
No, just, no, it was really, I think it was the most comfortable costume I've ever had to wear, because it was leggings, just long johns, and they're so comfortable, flat boots, comfortable, just wrapped with a little bit of rope. The shoulder padding, obviously it's built for athletes to wear in football games, and so it's designed to be comfortable. It's bulky. You don't have a full range of movement in it, but it's designed beautifully. So, and it is designed for football players to have a pretty full range of movement. So, it didn't restrict me that much. Actually, the costume was incredibly comfortable, and it just had a piece around the waist with some studs on it, really, really comfy. The only part about the costume, the whole costume that was uncomfortable, was the compound bow, because I had to...
Pull back the tension all the time.
Yeah, and I can't remember what the poundage is, but it's something like, I could be wrong, so forgive me. I seem to remember it was something like 30, it might have been 20, I might be exaggerating, 20 or 30 pound pullback, which is hard when you've got one arm stretched out and you only have the strength of part of your arm to pull it back. It was really hard to pull it back. And then the last part of the compound bow structure is very simple to operate, because it's easy then to pull back to there. But to actually hold it with that tension is extremely difficult. Mm-hmm. But when you're young, you love things to be difficult. You like to be challenged. So.
But they replaced it with a rubber band at one point.
Yes, as I was saying at the Q&A the other day. But yes, they replaced it about halfway through the film. Not because of any safety issues, but because of the fact that it was really hard to hold. And if you were using it in the wild in primitive times and you wanted to hunt some food, you wouldn't be holding it cocked for that length of time. You just wouldn't. You'd be releasing it and lifting, you know.
So just to get that shot, it's like...
To get several
shots.
You just
hold that for
an hour, cut and move around. The camera's going to move around you. We need you just to hold, you know, things like that. So you had to hold on to it quite a lot. That was a little bit challenging. But the rest of it was easy. I wish I had all of the pieces from Mad Max, because it would be amazing to have that costume. It's such an iconic costume. But no, alas.
I have to kiss this movie star. Oh, beautiful to see you, okay? Hope that's coming in, okay?
Thanks, gorgeous.
Anything you wanted to share about Norma, whether it's a story or just, if you just want to talk about her a little bit?
Norma,
What your impression of her was?
Genius. I don't know how she created the look of Road Warrior. Extraordinary person. There's no designer like, I'm sure there are other designers like her who have invented a new genre that lasted for, how many designers are out there that design a look for a film, production design a film, and that look exists in normal fashion every day, everywhere you look, for 35 years and still going. Where do you think Mohawks came from? You know, I mean, originated from the punk era, but she took aspects of punk, aspects of bondage, to be honest, aspects of traditional clothing, kilts and God knows what, and normal everyday wear and military wear and biker wear and rock wear and every kind of genre imaginable, and she mashed it together and created the whole look of Mad Max. And it's the most extraordinary combination of grabs from different cultures and different fashions and styles and traditions. Who else could do that? You know, no one had thought of it before her. I can't imagine there would be anyone else who has designed and, like I said, had those designs move into normal culture. People with mohawks, shaved sides of hair. You see pop stars. You see people in the street every day. with that now spiky hair that came from Mad Max. You know, people have been copying it, the dress, the fashion. Okay, yes, the she copied, you know, bondage, punk, rock, and all of those other things. But there's a particular look that came out of Mad Max. It's very unique to Mad Max that people have copied now since then, the years. So what do I think about her? You know, just absolute genius. And what, that, who knows? I would love to, I hope she had a chance to write a book before she passed away, because I would love to creep inside her mind and find out what motivated her, what led her to that point, and find out what she did after, because I haven't spoken to her for so many years. But really, such a talent, like a prophet of fashion, a prophet of film fashion. You know? Yeah, she'll be sorely missed. Academy Award winning. You know? Yeah, she deserved it. Yeah, brilliant.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.